Hello YouTube, K4DPS back again, and we're going to take a look at how to enter a conventional frequency in the Whistler WS1095 digital scanner. The very first thing we need to do is head into the menu, so we'll press the menu button there. We're going to arrow down until we get to enter conventional frequency. We'll arrow over to the right. And the very first thing we're going to do is enter in the actual frequency. So we're going to head on over, and I am going to enter a fire attack frequency of 154.130. So it's on a 7 right now, so arrow down to 5. I'm going to arrow over, arrow up to 4, go over to the next decimal, past the decimal point, 1. Arrow over to the right. We're going to go down to 3. Arrow over to the right. Going to go down to 0. Arrow over to the right to get rid of that 5. All right. I have the frequency that I want to enter. It says select equals OK. So I'm just going to press the select button. I have the frequency. Going to arrow down to alpha tag because I'm going to name this particular frequency, and it is going to be TAC 1. So I am going to head over and find the T, move this over, and if you hold this down, it will actually page through all the letters and numbers for you, which is another nice feature. Arrow over to the right for my next letter, and I'll just hold. You can go up or down using your arrows. So like if you miss a letter, all right, I've got TAC. I'm going to put a space there. Next is going to be the number 1. All right, I have TAC 1. Now, in order to get rid of the O, N, and V, I am going to arrow up or down, and the actual blank is right after the number 9. So as you are going through these, once you get to number 9, if you press it again, that is your blank. So I'm going to do that to get rid of every one of these. And you can go up or down in order to get to that. So like if I move up, if it's closer to the number, it might be quicker for us. There's number 9. All right, now that I have TAC 1, I'm going to press select. Okay, I have the frequency, I have the alpha tag. Now it's time to set the scan list I'm going to put it in. So I don't want it in Florida Federal. I actually am going to page down, and I'm going to put that in scan list 12. Now you'll notice the arrow right here. Once you hit select, you'll see the check mark that puts it in scan list 12. All right, press the menu button to back up. The receive mode, I'm going to leave in auto. You can actually change it to AM, FM, or narrow FM, but I'm going to let the scanner decide and leave it in auto. Squelch mode is going to be the same, and we are going to page down. Now right here on search, if you want to, it will actually search for the tone code. Let's say that you actually know what the PL tone is for it. You can actually go, as you arrow over to the right, it's going to give you options. You can either search none, CTCSS, which is your PL tones, DCS, which is another digital coded squelch tone, NAC if it is a P25 channel, or search. Now I actually know what the tone is, so you can go to that, and I am going to take it off the search. Once I've taken it off the search mode, it actually comes up with the tone. So I'm going to arrow down to that, and I will actually move this to 173.8 because that is my PL tone for the Fire Attack 1. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and head down. I don't want to lock it out or skip. I'm not going to make it a priority. The delay is checked, so I know it's going to delay for 2 seconds. That's what I have it set on. No attenuation. AGC just helps the audio, whether it's high or low, it actually evens it out. Works very well, by the way. Okay, light, that is going to leave the actual light on the screen on, which that is what I'm going to do. You can have the light on, you can have it flash. So I am actually going to turn that light on because I want that on. The flash pattern, okay, that's how much it's going to flash. I'm going to leave it, I'm not going to mess with the flash pattern. On time, off time, I'm going to leave those alone. LED enabled, yes, absolutely. That brings in this little light right here. LED flash, I'm going to let it flash. Color count. Okay, this is where we get to decide what color we would like. Once we get to this, we can move this, and you'll notice that the light is now illuminating how bright it is. I'm going to leave red is perfect because red signifies fire in my eyes. So I'm going to put the color as red. Okay, so I'm going to select that. So it is enabled. It's going to flash. I had the color. I put it to red. Now, if you want to add colors, you may. You can add to any color that you'd like by moving these up and down and just mess around with it, see what type of colors will show up. But for now, I'm going to just leave it red. Okay, I've set my flash pattern. If you'd like to record, the scanner will automatically record any transmissions while it's scanning. So you can turn that on. Okay, once you have everything set, you're going to save changes. So arrow down to save changes, hit select, back to the menu, and now we are at the main menu, and in order to scan that, we want to go down to scan lists, over, and we want to add scan list 12 to the scan list by arrowing down to it, press select, press menu to get back, press select again to scan. And now you're scanning what you programmed in. Anyway, thank you very much for watching my videos. Have a great day.